On this episode of In Pursuit of Light, I want to be looking through the desert of Canyonlands National Park for False Kiva. Stopped by the ranger station to get directions to False Kiva, which he was happy to give me, but it was explained that it's a Class 2 archaeological site, and they prefer that the directions aren't made public. However, if you're looking for this, you can always stop in at the ranger station at Island in the Sky, and they'll be happy to show you on a map where it's at. Okay, because we're getting ready to head into the backcountry here, in addition to our camera gear, we also want to make sure we have the tent essentials with us. Those are the tent essentials for any kind of outdoor backcountry travel. Number one is a map and compass. I've got the map of the park here, and I also have a compass in my bag. You want to have extra water, really important in the desert, extra food. In addition to that, you're going to want extra clothing. I make sure to always have a good hat with me. Also have a jacket here that's nice and compressible so I can stuff it into my backpack. In addition to that, you're going to want a headlamp or flashlight. I think this is going to be really important because I have a feeling I'll be hiking back in the dark tonight. Also, you want to have sunscreen, sunglasses. I have sunscreen here in my first aid kit, which is something else you want to have. Also in the first aid kit, I have matches and a lighter, along with some hand sanitizer that contains alcohol that I can use to start a fire if I need to. In addition to that, you should always have a knife or a Leatherman, some kind of tool with you. It's really important to carry all this stuff with you. I know it seems like a lot, but you know, you should never try to just rely on a cell phone, even though it works really good in an urban setting. You get out here in the backcountry, you don't have service, it breaks, the batteries die, and you can be in a bad situation. So just make sure you're carry the right stuff to be safe, and everything should be fine. You know, after a while, all of these canyons start to look alike. So it's really important that every once in a while I turn around, look behind me just so I have my bearings, so that when I go to hike out of here at night, I can find my way. Well, I'm pretty certain this is the trail. But I'm not going to know until we get over close to the edge there and I can look over the side. That drop has got to be close to 1,000 feet. And I'm pretty sure I can see where we're headed. So the sun just dropped behind this cliff over here,
and it got a lot colder. The temperatures dropped at least 10, 15 degrees. So I'm gonna keep moving so that I don't need to put on another layer. This place is incredible. I see the Kiva just up ahead. So this alcove here opens almost due south. So the first thing I'm going to try is to put a polarizer on here. One of the things, the way a polarizer works, it'll really darken the sky, especially when it's at a right angle to the sun. Since the sun is now setting in the west, due south should maximize the polarizer's effect. And I'm just going to compose a shot here. And then if you look through the lens with me, you'll be able to see what the polarizer is doing. As we turn it, it gets lighter and darker, at least the sky anyway. Now the other thing I'm really going to want to do here is do a lot of bracketing, because there's such a big difference between the light that's hitting the landscape out in front of me and the light that's hitting the inside of the alcove. So what I'm looking at here is a scene that has too much contrast in it. The inside of this alcove is much too dark compared to the direct sunlight that's hitting everything out there in the valley. So what I'm going to do is use my neutral density graduated filter. I'm going to drop that in front of the lens. And then if you look through the lens with me, I'm going to hold down the depth of field preview button here. And you can see the effect that it's having as I move the filter up and down. And what I'm going to do is just kind of block out just right to the top of the Kiva there. And then get a couple shots in. And of course, I'm going to bracket in 2/3 of a stop increments. Cool. The other thing I'm going to do is take a look at the histogram on the back of the camera, and that'll give me a lot of information as to where I need to be on my exposure. The term False Kiva comes from the fact that archaeologists aren't exactly sure what this site was used for, but it's not actually a kiva. Please keep in mind when you visit any archaeological site to leave it in the same condition that you found it in.
Pursuit of Light is brought to you by Altitude Fine Art Photography Gallery, featuring fine art prints, gifts, photography workshops, and more, located in Breckenridge, Colorado. Learn more at altitudegallery.com. And by Click Elite Performance Packs for Adventure Photographers.